Hello and welcome back to Creepy Poem of the Day. I'm John Joseph Ryan. Today's poet is John Joseph Ryan. Not much is known about this poet. He was born beneath a flaming palm tree in Temple City, California, during a spate of wildfires that forced his mother out of her car and thus cheated her of her dream of giving birth in the back seat of a Volkswagen Beetle and thus winning some prize money. After that, the record is pretty murky, until Ryan attended the dubious Institute for Higher Consciousness on the island of St. Lucia, hoping to earn a certificate in psychedelic therapy. Unfortunately, he was kicked out after secretly dosing his professors and taking over several classes to subject fellow students to early drafts of his poems. Despite his professors regaining their wits and having him removed from the school, the students loved his poems and offered him valuable feedback on their development. Today, Ryan lives in relative obscurity, which he prefers, and sometimes surfaces in order to publish a new poem or host YouTube shows for special occasions. In today's creepy poem, Shades, John Joseph Ryan imagines human beings' relationship to shades, those restless spirits who cannot quite seem to loosen their hold on the earth and move on to the next plane. John Joseph Ryan, Shades. Shades separate us from the light. Shades of the damned do the same. They cordon off the light in a bare human form, a mirror cut to size that does not reflect, but absorbs. At night they are invisible. If we are intuitive enough, we feel the brief pockets of absence in the wind as they pass. By day, they are lurkers of a high degree. We feel their tug in the pulling at the sleeve by an unwelcome hand, the chance encounter with an old lover, the figure in the moving crowd that pauses ahead of us, the slight woman who rounds a corner just out of sight, the gaunt waiter ushering himself through a flapping kitchen door, the remains of a struck hound. They're the reminders that make us clutch purses tighter, pull children closer, kiss longer and harder. In a day or so, we will forget seeing them and relax our hold on those present. The dead, though, have longer memories and no future to plan for.